Welcome to the FDA catch-up on the X-Reel Beam versus the X-Reel Beam Pro. This video is a comparison between some features of the X-Reel Beam and the X-Reel Beam Pro. If you're interested in knowing what the X-Reel Beam is or what it could be used for, please check my X-Reel Beam video. Now, let's go and compare. As you can see here, the X-Reel Beam Pro has abandoned the portable smaller size and gone for a full Android phone size. X-Reel also got rid of the internal fan in the X-Reel Beam and took advantage of the new shape of the X-Reel Beam Pro to add a couple of cameras to allow recording 3D SBS video, or also called spatial video or taking spatial photographs. Also, both the X-Reel Beam and the X-Reel Beam Pro support smooth follow as well as the anchor mode. The only exception might be the side view mode that seems to have been moved away or not easily available from the X-Reel Beam Pro. Both devices come with a video player that allows watching 3D SBS video. In case you don't know, to enter in 3D SBS mode, start watching your video as usual, for example using VLC, and while the side-by-side video is being played, remember to press and hold the plus key from your X-Reel Air 2 Pro glasses until you hear a beep. After this, it would enable the 3D mode. Something similar happens with the Vitcher XR Pro glasses. Just press the single button for glasses. But what are the most notable changes or improvements? The fan. The X-Reel Beam has a fan that might become a bit noisy, and interestingly, the temperature observed is higher than the temperature observed while using the X-Reel Beam Pro. For the X-Reel Beam, the temperature was up to 50 degrees Celsius, whereas for the Pro version, it was just 36.7. Android. The X-Reel Beam Pro presents itself as an Android 14 device, and unlike its predecessor, you can configure most aspects of the X-Reel Beam Pro as if it was an Android phone, which it technically is, but without the SIM card support. Better hardware. The X-Reel Beam just had 4GB RAM with 34GB space, for which only around 22GB were usable. This was powered by a Rockchip RK3566 processor, whereas the X-Reel Beam Pro is powered by the Qualcomm Snapdragon 6 Generation 1, which, being from 2023, it is already a better processor than the one used by the first generation of the X-Reel Beam. It is not the latest, it is not the greatest, but it is better. The X-Reel Beam Pro has a version with double the RAM with 8GB and much more storage, up to 256GB, and it is certainly more powerful than the first generation of the X-Reel Beam. AR space. There's been some work from X-Reel in terms of the AR space. The navigation feels better while using the X-Reel Pro and compatible apps. There's an X-Reel store that allows installing AR space specific apps, something that didn't exist when the X-Reel Beam was first released, although still very few apps and games are available at the time of recording. Games in the X-Reel Beam Pro are quite basic but fun to play and show the potential of the device. The navigation in the AR space feels better than using the Nebula app or the X-Reel Beam first generation. The question is, how long does it take for the company to stop being experimental and actually have a bigger number of apps and start showing a faster improvement? Camera. The X-Reel Beam doesn't have any cameras, but the X-Reel Beam Pro comes with two cameras that allow recording spatial videos and spatial photographs. The video stabilization is not great. Also, I noticed that the cameras don't seem to allow digital zoom while recording the video. The resolution of the video is 3840 by 1080. The X-Reel Beam Pro opens the possibility of allowing you to easily record your own 3D SBS videos. Now, to me, recording itself is an art. as, for example, recording at the right distance would highlight the 3D effects and everything would look amazing, but recording too close and it would make the viewer dizzy. So there's a fine line in which the video could be great or simply awful to watch. Stay tuned for a short sample video recorded with the X-Reel Beam Pro. Apps. The X-Reel Beam used to rely mostly on sideloading apps or using what X-Reel has explicitly allowed you to. With the X-Reel Beam Pro, you can still sideload apps if you wanted to or install custom APKs. But for regular users, there's the option to install your apps directly from the Google Play Store. Yes, which is something that makes testing different apps easier than before. Interesting findings. Feature XR Pro compatibility. It is possible to use the Feature XR Pro to watch 3D videos with the X-Reel Beam Pro in air casting mode, as long as you use VLC or any other compatible player. Using the Speedwalker app results in an unplayable video. The app runs and seems to be okay until you actually try to play a video. It just stops and doesn't work properly. Unresponsiveness. The X-Reel Beam Pro seems to be unresponsive at times, and it requires to be restarted by holding the power button for around 20 seconds. A new version 1.3.0.1207 was released to correct an issue with the pause functionality of the Netflix application. This is all for now. If you want to get notifications whenever I have something to say, please don't forget to subscribe. If you haven't, thank you for watching and see you later.